Say you want to buy a dream car. Okay? So if you buy a dream car, what dream car will you buy? A Lamborghini. This guy's got class, man. Lamborghini. Any of the girls, do you like cars? If you were to buy a car, what? An Audi, okay? This nice taste toy. Young lady, what would you buy if you bought a dream car? A Mercedes-Benz? Yeah, probably. Okay, now each one of us, even parents, think about it. You buy a dream car, all of us want a dream car, something really high-end. And I had this friend of mine who bought a Jaguar. Okay, we studied together. He bought a Jaguar. He said, Ryan, you know what? I have three cloths for my car. One cloth for the wheels, one cloth for the paint, and one cloth for inside. And I never mix any of the cloths. Okay? My car, ordinary Skoda, man. One cloth inside, outside, under, everywhere. Now what happens? If you are a dream car, so I want you to imagine your dream car. So imagine you're a Lamborghini. The Lamborghini requires special cloth to clean it, special fuel, everything. Now you take this sports person in you. Mommy, today I want to have Pepsi and pizza. Lamborghini is putting kerosene inside it. So the question is, when you put this Lamborghini in the water, okay, do you want it to go but super fast. Swimming is that. Swimming is one of the most difficult sports in the world. By far, if you're doing swimming, you're already here in my eyes. Okay? But then you eat samosa, batata vada, and Pepsi pizza, you're here. Okay? So food is very, very important. Everyone understands this. Food is very important. So, did parents read today's newspaper, Times of India? When you go home, please take it. There's an article on the heart rate of runners and swimmers. Take out that article. You're putting an insurance policy on the health of your children for the rest of your life. Because in India, we have the highest genetic rate of heart disease. This part of the world, unfortunately we're born here, 1.3 billion, I think it's very fortunate. We have genes. You know what genes? Not bad genes. Human body has something called as DNA, gene. All of you have phones? In the phone you have seen an app, correct? The app inside you is called a gene. So there is an app for long hair, there is an app for curly hair, there is an app for when you should go bald. So if Papa is already balding, that app is switched on already. Okay? Like that, there is an app for nutrition. So swimming confers a certain health on the heart for future. So even if your child never represents India, you've given them the biggest asset, which is building a stronger heart. Okay? And how do we fuel this heart? We put food in our body. So let me give you an example, okay? Let's start today. Science says, if you want to be tall, now, will a short swimmer swim faster or a tall swimmer swim faster? Short swimmer swim faster? Yeah, what is Michael Phelps' height? 6'4". So 5'5" if you are. Michael Phelps' arm is there, your arm is here. All of you under the age of 14, girls under the age of 12, you are in the period to get your height growth. If you eat like Maruti 800, if you eat like rickshaw, then your height is also affected. Not only speed, height also. Okay? So, research shows that you need to have 5 servings, pay attention, 5 servings of fruits and vegetables per day to grow tall. Okay? So, now I'm going to do an exercise with all the parents and everybody. If you've eaten one fruit or one vegetable today, raise your hand. And keep your hand up, okay? Just humor me. Keep your hand up. Have you eaten 2 fruits or 2 vegetables today? If you've not, put your hand down. If you've eaten 3 fruits or 3 vegetables today, keep your hand down. If you've not, put your hand down. It's already 6 o'clock in the evening. If you've eaten 4 fruits and 4 vegetables today, keep your hand down. You get what I'm trying to say? Parents, are you getting it? Now children, you're looking at Cheetos, you're looking at Lay's, you're looking at Pepsi, you're looking at Coke, you're looking at Maggie noodles. None of these guys are the fuel for you to become a Ferrari. And that's what a nutrition coach is supposed to do. Like for example, okay, you just jump in the pool, you become Michael Phelps? No, you need a coach. Give me an example of one stroke in swimming. Freestyle. Now freestyle, okay, can you be my friend over here? Okay, just stand over here. I don't know what is freestyle, okay? I'm unsure in swimming. Show me your arm movement for freestyle. Okay, now he's doing that, huh? Yeah, I know, I can be Michael Phelps. Freestyle, no? Super. This is samosa, bata, tabata, everything. Now do it again properly. This is fruit, vegetable. Am I doing correct? Okay, little bit. You get my point. Everyone's getting my point. You need coaching. You need coaching. You want an orange, you're gonna help me, okay? You need coaching to tell you what to eat correctly. Now, I have a $1 million question. Who is teaching you how to eat correctly? Parents, who is teaching you to eat correctly? I saw only 3 or 4 parents at 4 fruits and vegetables. All of you are failing, okay? And you know what? You should catch your parents when they are not eating correctly. Okay? If your papa has a tummy, no, go and hey, daddy, what is this petrol tank? Okay? Parents, by the way, children have the highest best of power to be getting fitter. So I'm working both ways. You're going to shout at them, they're also going to poke you. So coming back, 5 servings of fruits and vegetables. Did you see today? So girls, you want great hair, you want height, you want beautiful skin. It's 5 fruits. Whenever we put something with high sugar in it, okay? Does anyone have a tetra pack of anything over here? Like a tetra pack of juice or lassi or anything? Would love to have something. No? Nobody has? Good. We are all very good people over here. Okay. Parents, I want you to do this exercise. Tomorrow's a holiday, Sunday's a holiday. Take your kids shopping. Go and get a tetra pack of lassi. 250 ml. I want all of you to do this exercise. Turn the packet around and see how many grams of sugar is there in it. Okay? Before I tell you, 5 grams. Anyone knows how many teaspoons? 1 teaspoon is 5 grams. And Amul Lassi has 6 teaspoons of sugar in a 250. Exactly. Correct. I did the same thing. I did this. Oh my God. 6 teaspoons of sugar. Like, suppose I come to your house now. Come. Ryan's come. Huh? Big Shot Nutritionist has come. He wants Lassi. How many teaspoons of sugar will you give me? Maximum 1, correct? Hey, he's nutritionist. You can't give more sugar, man. Maximum you put 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now what happens is, when that 6 teaspoons of sugar is in a lassi, who is very happy? Tongue is super big. Hey, Bangra, yes, give me 6 teaspoons of sugar. Right? You're super happy. Who's happy? Tongue. Guess what? What happens to your muscles, your growth, your hormones? They're like, oh my God, you are killing us. Because the brain says, hey, tongue's got super pleasure, 6 teaspoons of sugar. Research has actually shown you go slower, but you take more sugar in your diet. Research says you go slower when you take more sugar in your diet. So if I was you and I wanted height, I wanted beautiful skin and hair, I want to go fast in my pool, I avoid foods that have added sugar in it. And how do you find added sugar? Buy the product, turn it around. See how much sugar is there in it. Ideally speaking, as a child, you should not consume more than how many? 4 teaspoons of sugar in your entire day. Right? So that's the job of a nutrition coach. He's supposed to tell you what to do and how to do. And today I'm going to take all the questions from everyone because you will have specific questions. But What I want to convince you is, what you put into your body will define whether you are Tata 309 truck, your auto rickshaw, your Maruti 800, your Honda City, or you are a Mercedes or Lamborghini. The power of an athlete is dependent on what they put into their body. A lot of my athletes cheat me. They will say, sir, tournament is coming up. 1 week away, I will eat very disciplined. Your body knows what you have done. Let me give you a secret. It is 2 months of proper eating before your body starts responding. You want to swim 29.52? Start eating correctly 2 months prior. Now, I'll ask you this question. How many times a day do you sleep? Once a day? Twice a day. Everyone sleeps twice a day if you're swimming. Sometimes if you're lucky, you can get 3. You do an after morning nap and an evening nap. Parents, please let your children sleep. If they are into competitive sports, let them sleep. Make violin less. Make dance class less. Let your children sleep, because I have more than 6,000 children coming to us for the last 20 years. Identical twins, piano player, tennis player. Guess who's taller? Why? She gets more sleep, she gets more food, grows taller. So the question is, you want a sporting kid, but the kid is not sleeping enough, and the kid is not eating enough. Therefore, the child gets stunted. Key learning for parents. You are winning it. You think you are Google. You are feeding your child very, very nicely. Brilliant. It was our grandparents' age where they had 9 children to experiment. Superb. Most of us, I have 1 kid. You may be having 1 or 2 kids. You need to give them the right type of food, because of the confusion today in the insecticides and pesticides in the food. The junk that these kids want to eat, including that lassi which has 6 teaspoons of sugar in it. So we have to teach the children better education. So everyone should sleep once or twice a day. Kids, switch off your mobile phone by 8 o'clock in the evening, please. You are not the Prime Minister of India, and neither am I. Okay, I think even Nisha doesn't need to be contacted at 8 o'clock in the evening, am I right? Like, madam, I forgot my breaststroke today. Call me tomorrow morning. There's nothing important. Cardiovascular surgeon, doctors, they need to pick up the call 24/7. Kids, after 8 o'clock, the mobile phone affects your sleep. It alerts your brain. You need to shut it down. And people, you know, parents say to me, no, you know, but how do we take away the mobile phone from our children? I've got a simple answer. Speak to your parents and ask them, how did you discipline us? It's as simple as that. Please take away the mobile phone at 8 o'clock in the evening. They don't need it, because all the children, they tell me in the private counseling when they're 13, 14, mother goes out to the loo, she says, Ryan uncle, actually I'm on the WhatsApp till 11 o'clock at night. The door's closed, so mommy, daddy don't know I'm on the phone. But the kid's telling me this. And I tell the kid, hey, listen, you need to sleep. Why do you need to sleep? Because you want to grow taller. You have less sleep, you'll be shorter. How many people want to be short? I thought so. Everybody wants to be tall, so you need to sleep. So, we all sleep once or twice a day. Hey, how many times a day do you swim? Once or twice? Once or twice? Wow, very important. Sleep, very important. Swimming, very important. Hey, how many times a day do you have a shower? Twice. Once? Once, if you're a sports person, mostly twice. Otherwise, the guy sitting next to the girl sitting next to you is smelling right now. Okay? So, swimmers, you're lucky because you're in the water all the time, so you don't smell that much. So you're swimming twice a day? Good. Hey, 40. 40. Number 2. How many times a day? Hey, it's important. I'm a nutrition coach. I have input and I have output also. Correct? If you talk about both sides, you're not only input, output also. How many times a day do you take a dump? Twice. Athletes have to go twice, because listen, parents, if your kid is not dumping twice a day, you're not an athlete, or you're not feeding them enough. Because a normal kid will require, let's say, 1500 calories. When they put into Nisha's pool, they're burning another 1000 calories a day. That's almost double of what they need to eat. In fact, most kids' parents eat more than you in terms of calories. So it has to come out. So if your kid is not dumping twice a day, you're not feeding them right now. So we said what? Sleep twice a day, shower twice a day, swim twice a day, potty time twice a day. How many times a day do you eat?
Five?
Yeah. Even if you have an orange, I consider it a meal. So how many times a day? Parents? Once, twice, breakfast, lunch, dinner?
Arre Baba, breakfast, lunch, dinner is for aam aadmi. Ye to aam aadmi ke liye. Tum aam aadmi hai?
Sorry, I can't use those terms. No, now election is on. I can't use all those terms like that. So, a good Olympic level swimmer will consume close to 10,000 calories at adult stage, which is 8 meals a day. So, Nisha madam, respectfully, the incidences of exposure of eating is far more important than even swimming. So, when I spoke to Nisha, I said, my job over the next 10 years, if I want an Olympic medal winner in swimming, has to start with you kids today. And you cannot come to me because a lot of the athletes, before Rio Olympics, 2018 is before Rio, Indian government released 60 lakhs. I had everyone calling me up, Ryan sir, diet plan banao. I'm like, what can you do eating one banana 20 days before the Olympics? You have become more of a monkey than a national level swimmer. Nutrition is long-term, 8 times a day. So there's so much of focus. Okay, here's the problem. Please remember this. You believe that I have swum so hard that I'm entitled to eat what I want. The Lamborghini said, oh, I am racing. Now you put samosa, batata vada, kanda, batata, everything inside this Lamborghini. Instead, I say, swim really hard. Take your Lamborghini, take your Mercedes, take your Ferrari, to the petrol station and say, I want beetroot, I want orange, I want dry fruit, I want dates, I want milk. Uncle Ryan, I'm allergic to milk. Okay, remove milk, put in curd. I don't like curd. Okay, remove curd, put cheese. I don't like cheese. Oh, you don't like dairy? Fine, parents, you don't need to feed dairy. You can make mango milkshake with coconut milk. What I'm trying to communicate to all you youngsters over here, what you do is you try and cheat your body with rewarding your tongue, and then your skin, your hair, your body, everything is like one Kandara 800. So what you put into your body to look good, stand tall, grow tall, is about what you put into it, and then how you put it in gets you your skin. So, one commitment I want you to make to me, one commitment, every day I want you to count the number of vegetable and fruit you eat. If you have not hit 5 vegetable and fruit, so it can be anything, fruit and vegetable. If you like only fruits, parents, it's okay. You know, parents come to me, hey, which parent over here gives karela to their children? I'm going to shoot you right now. Children, point out your mother, father who's giving you karela right now. No karela to your children. Karela is only for us adults. It has no nutritional value, madam. Instead, broccoli. Instead, cabbage. Instead, tomato. Instead, beetroot. Instead, radish. Instead, beans. Okay, so you can eat beans? Yeah. Can you eat like a tomato? Yeah. Can you eat a carrot? Yeah. So get the vegetables from the main guys. Okay? Any kid over here who hates fruit? You hate fruit. All fruit. Which you eat? No, I want somebody who hates fruit. Tell him which fruit you hate. All fruits. Okay, now, no, it's okay. If she hates, I love the honesty. So she said she hates all fruit. There are people genetically born who have receptors that do not like certain types of food. For example, from 10,000 years ago, her sheep pool would have been living in an area maybe where there are only animals. Or maybe there's only crop, or there's no fruit, there's only vegetable or tuber, we don't know. So what I do in such a case, I ask only this question. When you eat a fruit, darling, do you feel like puking? Yeah, so she feels like puking. So when you feel like puking, in the younger ages, we don't push the child. We find alternatives.
when they become 13, 14 adult mindset, we say that, hey, do you know that pomegranate seeds have 5 omega fatty acid, which gives you beautiful skin and hair. But you have to eat the seeds. By the way, the seeds also, you know, when you do a lot of swimming, your muscles get sore 24 hours later. Has any of you felt that? Like your thighs are sore, or calves are sore, or the shoulders get very sore, like you lift it up, like a sweet pain comes. That's called DOMS, delayed onset of muscle soreness. All the senior swimmers, you will get this. Pomegranate, eat it with the seed, reduces DOMS. Now what happens, parents, what I just did, is that young girl over there will not eat a pomegranate because she's a gag reflex. Anybody over here who hates pomegranate will now suddenly think, I got soreness, maybe it's time I start eating this. And trust me, for the last 10 years this has worked. If we educate our children on why they need to eat something, and by the way, they never listen to mommy and daddy. They don't. My kid doesn't listen to me. I've got to get one of my dietitians to talk to him. And this is very good. And he said, and that's the case. My own parents don't listen to me. Like my mother said, why should I listen to you? The moment I bought her a plant, she said, oh, you know, Swashni, my head died. Oh, you know, Swashni said to eat this, Swashni said to eat that. So children never listen to their parents. So don't even attempt. There are people like coaches who will educate your children to eating correctly, provided you understand what you want from your child. If your child is here just for recreation, you know what? One dadi maa's nimbu pani, perfect. Give one an orange to your kid before they come to practice. By the way, do all of you eat before you all come? At least 1 hour before? 45 minutes before? Brilliant. Okay, now I want to take example. What did you eat 45 minutes before coming? Dal rice. Good option. What I would do with the dal rice, you're a vegetarian, non-vegetarian? Vegetarian. Could I add a cheese slice to that? You could add a cheese slice. Why? Because I want to pull up the protein slightly. Okay? What did you have before coming in? Oats. Okay, so oats is good. Can you put some dry fruit in that oats? Right? So some kismis, some cashews, some almonds. Great. What did you have? One yoga bar? Hey, I find that dude, my yoga bar. Okay, yoga bar. Then. Milk? Didn't have milk today? But anyone had a mango today before coming in the swim? Awesome, dude, awesome. Parents, let children eat mangoes, okay? So I have parents coming to me, sir, sugar is there, no, in madam. Hey, hello, these children are not diabetic. Problem is with y'all, not with the children. Okay? So please eat mango. Do not deny your children something that nature has given in its own packaging. Huh. If it comes in a plastic, then there's sugar. Okay? The research in sports nutrition says one of the best recovery drinks is a simple chocolate milkshake. If your child doesn't have milk, you could switch to oat milk, coconut milk, or almond milk. I don't recommend soya milk because for girls it affects the menstrual cycle, and for boys it stunts testosterone. So we don't want boys that are a little shorter, right? So keep this in mind. We want not to give. Okay? Girls, what did you have? Nothing. You had sweet potato. Brilliant. Research shows sweet potato has an amino acid called lysine. What's the name of the amino acid? Lysine. I want you to remember lysine as your future girlfriend. Okay? So your future girlfriend is lysine, sweet potato. Lysine helps the muscles fire faster, better, stronger. But there's a secret. Sweet potato, listen in closely, parents. Sweet potato is better given post-swimming. So you go home and give your mom a nice kiss and say, Mom, Ryan said sweet potato very good, but let me have it after. And I would do probably like a bowl of porridge, because you want something to digest fast. Should you do a biryani before coming to swim? You're fart in the bowl, right? No, it won't digest. Because the rice will enter to the stomach and say, hey boss, I have got to digest. Mutton has come, the chicken is saying, boss, I want to stand in stomach for 2 hours. Meanwhile, rice wants to go in front, chicken is saying, no, you please wait over here. Digestion is not happening. Suddenly when you come to the pool,
You're swimming, swimming, swimming. Your lactic acid goes up. You kids have heard of this word lactic acid? Yeah, it's the exhaust in your muscle. You know, your car, you're driving, you put petrol, no? Then the exhaust comes out. Inside your body, your exhaust is lactic acid. So the lactic acid builds in your muscle. Now lactic acid toxins come out. Yes, come out. You have too much food inside. Let's throw it all out. So you feel like puking. Have any of you swimmers puked over here? If you puke, you are a good athlete. Because you push yourself. And parents, if your kid pukes, don't worry. It's acidosis. Because the acidity goes so high that they have to puke. You can reduce this acidity by including guava in your diet more often. What? You know what's a guava? It's a vegetable, no? Are you sure? Hey, I'm Ryan Fernando, man. Are you sure? Yeah, it's a fruit. Tomato, is it a fruit or vegetable? So these kids are smart, yeah? Wow, tomato is a fruit, you're absolutely right. So now that girl over there is confused. Should I eat tomato or not? Right? Darling, you like tomato? Like tomato? Tomato is a fruit. So you now can know one fruit. Okay? So she has one fruit. Okay, so we are now, everyone agrees with me, you have understood that nutrition is important. You need to choose and pick the right foods. As a group here, can you tell me, just raise your hand. Can you give me an example of a bad food? Raise your hand. I want a bad food. I want to know whether you know what is a bad food to eat or something like that. Girl in the green t-shirt. Yeah. Pizza. Okay. Can you catch? Okay. Can you pass this to her? Okay. Why is pizza bad?
Because a lot of fat.
A lot of fat in it? In fact, I don't know how many of you have watched the documentary. I can't take names because my colleague is recording. But there's a leading pizza chain that claims to have cheese in it. But it's actually emulsified fat. It's actually fat. Flavored with cheese. Okay, so you know what, a pizza is not bad if you make it at home. Yeah, good idea, no? Extra work for your mom, right? Okay, so you want to make homemade pizza, okay? And you want to put a lot of vegetables on that. Parents, by the way, tomato sauce is good if it's made at home. If you have the patience, I tried once, I don't have patience, it's a lot of headache. But research has shown tomatoes contain something called as lycopene. Lycopene is your girlfriend. His girlfriend is lysine, your girlfriend is lycopene. Okay? So lycopene is a red pigment in tomatoes. It boosts lung function. So a lot of swimmers over the years have come to me. I'm like, why tomato sauce they don't? And that kid was like, hey, so see, mama, he's saying I can eat tomato sauce. See, the tomato sauce has a lot of sugar, a lot of preservative in it. If you can make it naturally, then it's perfection. But if you can get our kids to have tomato soup, tomato juice, right? Or your pizzas made with a lot of crushed up tomatoes, it's excellent for lung function. Do swimmers require their lungs? Okay? Okay, give me one more bad food. Burgers? Pass this to her. Okay. Now let me ask you something. What's the difference between a burger and a sandwich? What's the difference? Is there any difference between a burger and a sandwich? Yeah, what's the difference? Oh, smart. Whenever you want to do an internship, come to my clinic. I'll make you join me for a nutrition clinic. Smart girl. Yes. So maybe it's fried. Okay, parents, this is for all the girls in the audience. When you fry food, it affects your ovaries. And because it affects your ovaries, you get a lot of pimples. So you want to reduce your fried food. I'll give an example, okay? Nisha and I, you and I will come in partnership. I'm nutritionist, you are the owner of a new restaurant. Okay? Both of us are going to go into business, all these people are going to be start eating our food. I am going to say, Nisha, I want Kadaknath eggs, 150 rupees each. Nisha, we will use organic onions and organic tomato. We will use extra virgin pure olive oil. Cost of omelette, 150 pounds. Nisha will say, Ryan, fellow, you are mad or what? Nobody in the pool will buy 150. Outside there's one table of fellow, he's selling omelette for 20 rupees. So somebody who's running a restaurant is making the most nutritious food or the most profitable food? More profitable? Girls, you agree? More profitable? Not kids. Think about it. The food you get from outside may be tasty because they are conning you. How are they conning you? Frying it with extra butter. Ghee. And then your taste buds like, oh, so good. Mama, your food is useless. Parents, have you ever noticed that? Huh? Your kids eat the French food and Mama, her mother makes such nice food, right? This happens, right? What am I trying to say to you? The food you're buying from restaurants is made out of profitability, my dear friend. And kids, if you're too young to understand profitability, maybe when you're older, come back to my seminar. You older guys, the stuff you get outside is cheap. But what your parents will buy or what you will buy be of the highest quality. And when you put that into your Ferrari goes super fast. So an omelette from the roadside or omelette from home, which is more nutritious? You get my point? So if a burger is made at home, it can be made very nutritious. Now parents are already asking how to make a burger more nutritious. Come to my car, nutritious. I want you to come. I want you to invest in a 3-month plan where your child and you come for education classes once a month. You learn about it. You do a blood test and things like that. So we've got two bad foods. Dosa? You love dosa. And suppose I put a lot of oil on it? So please understand one thing, okay? A food cannot be a junk food unless it is processed in the wrong way. So a pizza can be healthy, a burger can be healthy, a dosa can be unhealthy, a dosa can be healthy. How it's prepared is key. For example, roadside guy makes dosa. He is buying 10 rupee rice or he's buying 95 rupee rice. And what is your parent buying? Go home and check. Not 95, it's 135. Because your parents will buy you the best stuff, okay? Now, what do you think is my stance on chocolate? Okay? What do you think is my stance on chocolate? Do you think chocolate is healthy or do you think chocolate is unhealthy? All of you who say chocolate is healthy, raise your hands. You're taking a bit from my sale already.